So I got these Pure Sound Equalizer snare wires. This is the 16 wire version, and then I have 12 wire version on this Mapex snare. Let's see how it sounds like and maybe do some snare comparison with the other snares I have. Then I got this beautiful Sakai mahogany snare. I quite rarely use it, but it's good snare though, and expensive. I have this this beast, which is Tama SLP Big Black steel snare. This is a 14x8 snare. Then I heard Tama released a limited edition snare of the same snare, but 13x7. This is also has been like my main snare playing live, just because it's 13 inch, so it fits better on the drum set between your legs. That's the main reason. Live, I usually have this this Evans hybrid drum skin. It's quite expensive drum skin, but it's super durable. It's like 4 or 5 times more durable than your normal average Mylar drum skins. I think on the 13-inch snare drum, I have played like one whole tour plus all summer festivals with the same single drum head. So, yeah, there you go. So, now to the drum set and let's hear these things. Welcome to my home studio, aka my bedroom. So I just finished editing all the drum parts and
I figured out it might be actually quite cool to show you the basic processing and mixing I do to all my drum parts. So let's dive in. All right, so here we have the project. I recorded everything. It was just 170 ppm click I just played. So let's start here. Okay, so I didn't have any bass drum mics. I play both bass drums and I just don't have enough inputs on my audio interface. So I just have the triggers, these two, from my pedals, which by itself, they sound like this. That's the Foot Blaster trigger. And then just apply all this trigger. What else I have? A bit of treble and mid transient boost. And then what do I have here? Just bit of shimmer thickness and then half a decibel of earth. Then Proku 3. Let's see what this does. And then, so just get rid of the bit of nasty 6K on the transient and then just boost a little bit of a top end. Then to the snare, which was the main point on this video, so let's try with nothing and see how it sounds like. Yeah. Okay. So the microphone is Hale PR22UT, I think, which I got pretty cheap from the outlet store. So first of all, we go to into virtual mix rack. I didn't use any gate for this video, just to, you know, hear how the drum naturally rings out. So then I have just a preamp emulation, then virtual channel, just to know to clip the transient a bit. Then, you know, SSL boost high end, low end, a bit of Neve high end, just a bit of bottom end. And then I really like to do on snare have the distressor like slam quite hard, but then back down the mix map to a, like 50% or something. It gives a nice, you know, sustain and attack boost. Then just a bit of thickness. Next up we go to Transify again. Top end transient boost, slight middle boost. Then what I learned from my YouTube video, I don't remember what it was, but this guy did this thing that he put whatever gated verb you have, then just slightly put up the mix. If I would put this on 100%, yeah, but just slightly, you know. So it widens the snare like so much. And then you slam it here in Devil Lock Deluxe. What else? Okay. Some high-end boost and just to get rid of that low mid thump. What else do I have? Then spiff. Just to enhance even more the bottom and transient. This doesn't do anything right now. For the bottom mic, I give it like really simple. No gate. Usually I do that, but not now. High end, low end, then slam it with 1176 style with attack release on the fastest settings. And also I do this parallel compression, so it's only 50%. Then more high end, more high end, more bottom end. What else? Oh, this is cool preset. Let's bypass this. Oh wow. Really gives a nice thumb on the bottom snare. Then just gain minus 4 dB so it's not too loud. Together. Let's see here. So besides this Valhalla gate burp, I don't have any reverb now going on the snare. Next up we have toms. Where do we have? Here we have some tom fills. So first I hit it gate. This like just works wonders, this high tom preset on toms. And then you have the low tom for the floor toms, what I use. Okay, and then I think we go to virtual mix rack, and there I use also the Slate drum gate because of the deep lead function. So what this does, it gates the high end from this filter. It's like 2K right now, and then it opens the high end only for like 150 milliseconds. So what that enables me to do is to boost even more high end to have like really smacking attack on the tom-toms. Which, well, here I don't have too much actually going on. Then I like to use this 1176 on slow attack, fast release, 50% mix on the tom-toms, so it enhances the attack. SSL EQ doing nothing, then just a bit of thickness and a bit of volume. Next thing is Saturn. This I learned from Nolly Get Good video. Without it, it's like nasty mid mids and no top end at all. So here this is just separated to three bands. Then I have crossover 200 something. And then I pull down the middle band like almost 7 dB. And then top end crossover 2K. And then I boost it like plus 2 decibels. And then with this EQ here, couple of decibels. But you put the high end on gentle saturation and just crank it, and this gives this like really like, you know, when you smack tom-toms, you know, if I put the drive down, you know, no attack, when I put it back up, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. How about the second tom, how that sounds? Yeah, nice attack. Third tom. Oh, that might be too much. Yeah, at least there's attack. And then on the floor toms. Okay, do I have any else? Here it is. Yeah, how about the last tom? Oh, it's only there. Where is it? There we go. Yeah, that's some serious low end. And then all the tom-toms go to a tom bus. Just some dynamic EQ going on the nasty 3.5K Aria. And then there's a slight limiter, so which okay, now it should just, you know, take just a little bit of, you know, the initial attack away, so it's more controlled. Overheads. Let's go back here. Actually, here is quite a lot going on. Let's hear it by itself. So first I go to a slight limiter. Oh, it's not so slight actually. So it just ducks the snare a bit. We go to that later. And then virtual tape machine. And then we go to virtual mix rack. My overhead sounds like too boomy, not much, you know, top end, so I just boost it like tons here, even more. And then I just got this from Plugin Alliance, and then so because the limiter is doing quite a lot of work on the snare, this is mainly for balancing the cymbals. And I quite like this kind of really compressed overhead sounds. Then we have Sooth with the preset matter symbols. Just I have made this boost here on the very top on end because the hi-hats really get like really nasty on those, that really high area. After that I have Spiff doing only work here on that really high end. This is because I discovered when you hit the crash cymbal like so that the stick goes over the cymbal, not like on the edge like you normally would play, but when the stick hits the cymbal more, it creates this like really spiky transient on the really high end. So I played with this and I found out that this actually removes that quite nicely. Then sometimes if I have to, I have this multiband compressor, which is sidechained to the right / second hi-hat mic, and that sidechain is controlling this high band. Just because when you play the second hi-hat, it might get like too overwhelming on the overheads. So that's how you kind of it mixes itself basically. You listen to this, it's not nice. And with this sidechain thing you can really like control the high end even more without like doing lots of automation. And then lastly EQ. Just notching some, you know, small things. Let's see the right / second hi-hat mic without anything. Okay, and then we go to Virtu mix rack. So I have a low cut, 500, that's the max this goes. Then I have, you know, just a slight compressor thing going on. Nothing else actually. And then again we use this Soothe matte cymbals preset just to make it a bit more smooth. Then we go to EQ, where I don't really want this super high end on the close mic. I really like to focus on this mid area on the close mics. And then I have this, let's see, some bypass. Nothing drastic really, but I don't know, it makes something. And then I have this drum parallel bus where I send the bass drum, snares, and then toms a little bit of the overheads. This by itself sounds like this. And then if we listen to the whole mix, first just pull it down and then we bring it back up. Yeah, it really gives the life to the drums. Then everything goes to my drum bus. Then I have just minus 2 dB so it doesn't get too loud. Then we are to mix rack. Again, this is the mix bus stripe. High end little bit of, you know, middle, mid. Then I really like dig this FG Bomber, what it does to the, you know, transients. It's kind of like makes the whole thing more 3D, if that's even a thing. Then I have this Mark EQ2, little bit of air band, 2.5 dB. Without it, just a bit of air. This is from 2.5K. And then lastly, I have a tape machine again. And that's basically my drum processing. All right. Thanks for sticking so long with me, and see you next time. Oh, by the way, did you notice this really cool chrome taped SM58 I have here? It's cool, eh?